Hello everyone. Welcome to this video on how to connect data using Amazon Redshift data connectors in bold reports. You will see how to connect and retrieve data from a data source using the Amazon Redshift data connector, and how to integrate the retrieved data into a table report item. First, let me create a new report. I create a new report and name it Amazon Redshift Data Report. You can see how to create your first report in another video. I have provided a link to it in this video's description. Now, I'll create a data source using an Amazon Redshift data connector. I click the data icon in the configuration panel and click the new data button. In the data sources configuration panel, choose the Amazon Redshift connection type. In the name field, I enter the data source name, customer details. In the server name field, I enter the server name. The port field specifies the port number to access the PostgreSQL remote server. By default, the port number is 5432. In the username field, enter the username. I enter the password in the password field. Then enable the Save Password option to embed the credentials within the report. I click the drop-down icon in the database field to select a database and select Northwind Database from the list of databases displayed in the drop-down. To connect the data source with the connection string, click Advanced Options. The Name field, Username, Password field, and Save Password options are auto-filled from the basic options. Enter the connection string in the appropriate field. Here, see the connection string value filled from the basic pane. Connection strings are text representations of connection properties for a data provider. If the database is on your local computer, specify connection strings like this. If the database is located in any other server domain, specify the connection string with credentials like this. Next, select the type of authentication to authenticate the PostgreSQL database remote server. Authentication is selected by default as the authentication type, and you will be asked to enter a username and password. The prompt authentication type shows a prompt that allows the user to enter the username and password while previewing. The none authentication type is used when the authentication details are provided in the connection string. Now, let me connect to the database and create a dataset. In the basic option pane, click the connect button. The query designer page will open. It contains a schema area, query designer surface, toolbar, and preview area. The query designer surface is where queries are set up. It contains both graphical and text-based modes to create SQL queries easily. I change the name field value to customer dataset. For this demo, I'm going to add a customers table. I expand the public from the schema area and then expand the tables. I drag the customers from the schema area to the query designer and click Generate Preview. The preview of the customers table is displayed. Click the Finish button, and a data set will be created. Expand the data set to see the fields present in it. Now, I'll add a table report item and assign values to it. Drag the table from the item panel to the design area and add the necessary columns. I assign values to the header row and format them. Then assign values to the data row and format them. When I click the preview button in the top panel, you will see the values retrieved from the database and displayed in the table. In this video, I have shown you how to create a data source using the Amazon Redshift data connector and how to add the retrieved data to a table report item in Bold Reports. Stay tuned to this channel for our upcoming videos on Bold Reports. Don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.